Welcome back in the chapter Microorganisms. Students, I have explained you what are microorganisms and where they are formed and different type of microorganism. Yesterday also we have done useful why microorganisms are useful and how they can be used in different areas, isn't it? So let us discuss some more uses in detail today in this video. You know that for making curd, we are using lactobacillus bacteria, which convert the milk into curd. And today your activity was also given, that how to make curd from the milk, isn't it? So how your mother make curd for you people? She take a little amount of curd and add to a warm milk and keep it for a night or for some hours. Then what you see in the next morning, you see that a semi-solid curd is formed, that it is to be transferred to a cold place, and if otherwise the curd will become sore. You know that whenever your mother see that curd is set, then after that she put the curd in refrigerator so that it will become cool and it will not become sore in taste. Okay, but you know that milk contain a sugar called lactose. You must have read about glucose, isn't it? Your mother used to give glucose during summer. She mix in juice, in lime water for you people to get more energy, to get instant energy, isn't it? So this lactose is also a form of glucose. Okay, all these are the type of carbohydrate belonging to carbohydrate group. Glucose, lactose, maltose, sucrose. Sucrose is also a type of glucose which is found in sugarcane. Okay, maltose is found in wheat, in grains. Okay, you must have sometimes you take wheat grains and chew them. What type of taste you get when you chew the wheat grains? You get a small sweet taste, that is due to presence of maltose in it. Okay, so lactose is a glucose which is found in milk, and the lactobacillus bacteria is responsible for it conversion from milk to curd. Okay, and the lactose will be form lactic acid. Now the process of curd formation from milk is called curdling of milk. Here one flowchart is also given, that how you can make curd. It will make your learning process more easier if you see the flowchart. Sometimes in activities also such type of questions are asked, that how you can convert milk into curd. And here I have explained you bacteria for making cheese, isn't it? So a dairy product, cheese, paneer, these are also due to the useful effect of bacteria lactobacillus or streptococcus. Okay, just this cheese manufacturer, they add a substance that is called rennet, isn't it? That is obtained from the stomach lining of young cattle. You must have seen young cattle. From their stomach, this rennet substance is taken. It help in increasing the productivity. Okay, now yeast also is used for making bread. And here we are using fungus. Yeast is a type of fungus which help in making cake, bread, pastry, idlis, dosas, and dhoklas. You must have tasted them. If you see the dhokla, it is very spongy, isn't it? The cake is also very spongy. The spongy and softness occurs due to presence of yeast in it. Okay? Now, commercial use of microorganism. Commercial means at the industrial scale. If I want to make it for selling, isn't it? The yeast is also used in the production of alcohol. Alcohol, you know that fruit juice are used to convert it into alcohol. And yeast act as a intermediate substance, and as a, it contains enzymes, which you are going to study in higher classes. There are two enzymes present, that is interphase enzymes, which yeast contain and which help in fermentation of fruit juice into alcohol. We can make wines also and beer also by this. Okay, barley, wheat and rye and fruit juice are used for such type of for making such type of this alcohols. Okay, what will happen? Yeast grow in absence of oxygen and convert the food grains into alcohol, and especially the name given to alcohol is ethanol. Here it was explained. You see the Gujarati dhokla, it looks very good, and in taste also it was very tasty, isn't it? Your mother must be preparing for you people. The process of conversion of sugar in the absence of oxygen into alcohol is called fermentation. Fermentation means sadana galana, isn't it? Agar hum kisi cheez ko sadate galate hain, then, or especially sugar ko jab sadate galate hain, then it will become alcohol in the presence of yeast and in absence of oxygen. Okay, then citric acid. We are using citric acid. You must have eaten vinegar, isn't it? Vinegar, citric acid, these are the type of acids which you can easily eat. You are not suggested to eat all the acids. Only citric acid, which is mostly present in sour substance like lemon, orange, unripe mango. Okay, and this aerobic bacteria, acetobacter, which is used in the formation of vinegar. You must have heard the word sirka at your home. That is also acetic acid. When mixed with water, it forms vinegar. And from alcohol, we can prepare so many other things also. You know that from alcohol, we are preparing cough syrups also. So, the microorganisms are useful at our home also, in industries also. And now come to in